was Batrider as well as Templar Assassin playing around. The Prophet now will TP in for this one. He needs to go towards the high ground. The charge is coming in over on Tricky, but he will get the kill over on the Templar Assassin. But the charge is on the way in. It will actually be the double kill. The charge should still get it, but no, he backs out.
Because that minus armor is so useful when you're, you know, charging in, Nature's Prophet TPs in.
He's going to have to get a level of it right now. Actually, no, he doesn't. He's a 3-0-2. The charge onto the Batrider, but the Infiz Jakiro appears. And they've got the slow with both the Dual Breath and the Liquid Fire. Central Ulti going to be triggered. That's allowing the Templar Assassin to run away. Still ignited up and ticking down while back in towards that middle lane. The bouncing cast making it difficult for Team Romania. And the Radiant boys, but can they find their target? The macro fire actually being used to keep the creep wave back. They might bring more support and he gets into the tree line. Ninth Ice Punk catching out two heroes with the liquid fire. The Sprout will isolate Necro. Then with the dual breath catching out two, the Necro ulti. Not enough damage, kills the Prophet. So Necro will go down. The charge is still coming in to the Oak Magi. Or TP himself out. They got the War Stomp in time from Centaur.
Late from Centaur, my god.
It couldn't have come at a better moment. Maximum, and there was no follow up after it, so it's better just to hold on to it. But good sentry wards getting rid of those TA traps in a minute. And now Centaur, three man, the horse on the charge coming in towards the Negro. Try and push it back to Ravage, however, interrupts it, drops the ulti down on the Centaur. He's down for a minute for the moment. Necro, there goes your pulse. How much damage is it? Not enough to get a kill just yet. Silky body blocks the Evo teammate, but the Ice Punk will buy that extra space. Zizu doing the work for the team. The Batrider trying coming close. The Flame Break doesn't cancel the TP away, but he still burns out inside the base. Illusions on 49 life points.
And we are still going on the Titan. Charge.
He has to run over the Firefly for an Anger Smash in quick, but it's just a match to go into a 10 life points on that Spirit Breaker. Charge is coming back in again towards that middle lane. Just nice path defensively into the tree line as Templar Assassin starts to dive in towards that Oak of Ajay. The bouncing cast unable to do some work as the lasso controls on Jakiro, but you've got the Centaur controlling even harder. Templar Assassin doesn't want to lose its Aegis Immortal while Illusionist. Well, there's no illusions about what he's trying to do. Dive deep down into the boys from the Radiant side, and then TA Trap close them all down. They can't keep up. The Ice Mask into the corner. Charge in 2 seconds time, and he's looking for another approach. He just powers in. He's gonna go into it, and he goes in for the Witch Doctor. This is not a smart idea. Stack anymore, he's gotta kill it off bottom lane. No Yulsa Rump just yet, but the Ice Paths will still connect. TA Trap being prepped, the charge coming in, Melt Strike. So the armor side to drop down, even though he's got a hell of a lot of it. Is there another one? The Macro Fire being thrown out as well as Batrider. No Lasso, 7 seconds on cooldown, but it's not stopping Weehar with that Haste Rune. Try and dive in, he's still got the Vision on the Necro. Aegis Immortal is gonna trigger in a moment because the tower damage, he could melt and possibly dodge it. He lets the Aegis go, the Ravage will trigger. And it's only the Centaur as well as SP that are affected, but they got so many life points they don't really care. TA turning back into the engagement on the Batrider, a little spill damage over towards the Witch Doctor. Needs another slow, or the Centaur blink down. That's a double kill for Weehar. And they're moving over with the charge in. Illusionist stopped up by the Fire Blast, but it's not enough damage to get the kill. And it's the Templar Assassin who freely moves around, picking up a triple kill. He might just die straight away. And they're coming back, and they haven't even brought down the T1 tower. Charge is going up towards the top. The rest of them are TPing out. They get the Vision over on the Necro, and Heal Drop as well, which will switch the charge over towards that Ogre. At least it should do so, as now he's being macro-pied up. TP out, the timing, it is not enough. The purpose of smoke is four.
Also, when you've got some idea where the enemy is, because they've got no wards anywhere on the map. And Team Romania signal out. They're probably in our jungle trying to gang us, but no, they're heading into the Radiant Jungle. Batrider.
Smoke's going to break. The Haste Rune triggered by the Batrider. Who's he going to go on? The TA Trap. They turn around. They want to find the Time Hunter. He's getting banished up. Wrath of Major, not enough damage. Kill him. He'll get the Ravage off. Connecting on three heroes, but the BKB Templar Assassin still runs around. The Batrider tied so quickly in this fight. Necro throws the ulti out. It's enough damage to bring down Synergy, but I don't think it was with the ultimate, however. It was with his attack directly after the ultimate. So it's two for the price of one. Orphsop, too far away from the heroes, but Witch Doctor getting sliced with the double edge, ticking down from the pure damage of the urn. And this will now be the tier 3 tower in the bottom lane. No fortification available for Kino to actually make the jump. Jumps in, there it is. Lasso back, they need to try and protect Zizu right now. He's got Yulsa to remake, triggers to make the start with the charge. Okay, well that was the shortest charge in history. Templar Assassin being maligned up, Anger Smash as well, they need to get her out of here. There is still an Anger Seaborn on a hot stop on three. The Ice Punk to follow up onto two was broken free with that Kraken, but now an extra stun, it's a Centaur. He doesn't care about this, the damage isn't high enough. Templar Assassin back towards the front line, transition right now before Aegis blows up. She doesn't even die right now, again another beautiful Ice Punk from the Jakiro, moving up deeper, and they're losing too many heroes. They just cannot repel firepower of this magnitude from Romania. And they call GG just under 22 minutes. Very, very strong performance from Romania. I should be very happy with that. Very, very happy. The timings, everything that could have gone right for them in that game went right for them. They got the heroes they wanted and the timing they wanted.
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head. And that's what the strat is entirely based on. You know, you wait for level 3 on the Nectar's Prophet, level 2 on the Spirit Breaker, you get the TA up to level 4.